Good morning.
Morning.
Welcome to Unity of Madison. Thank you for choosing to spend time with us here. Whether online or in person, we feel your presence. After the service, we invite you to join us in the Namaste Cafe on our lower level. There's stairs and there's an elevator for your convenience. And we'll have some refreshments down there. My name is Joy Morgan, and I'll be your celebration assistant today. So if you would like, please stand for our opening song, We Are One Under the Sun. Well done. And it's nice that we can see the sun. We know it's up there, but sometimes it's a little elusive. This morning, our prayer chaplain is Jamie Gaylor, and Jamie will be happy to meet you in the prayer corner after service if you wish to send up some prayers for people in your circles. And Jamie will lead us in our opening prayer this time. Thank you, Jamie.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Beloved God, we are truly blessed today to assemble with other loving souls, hearing Unity's easy methods and teachings. It can help us become more self-aware, thus helping us shape our lives to become more loving and to prosper in all aspects. And we ask and accept healing of all our bodies, mind, and soul. And so it is. Amen.
Thank you. And again, if you wish, please stand and sing All You Need Is Love.
All right, before that, I'm just going to do a little prelude to it.
Thank you, everybody. That's a good way to warm up, and we're going to be hearing a lot more about love this morning. Our Unity weekend updates include our speaker schedule. Next Sunday, Reverend Richard will be coming to us virtually. And I believe one lesson will be live in person streamed, and the other one will be pre-recorded and presented to us. So we're very grateful for that. It is time to renew your membership. There are forms out in the foyer, and you can also renew online through the e-blast. Only active members can vote in our annual meeting, which is coming up, and so see the e-blast for further information. Absentee ballots for all elections coming up. are available by contacting the Unity office. I think the hours are up there. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Ballots must be returned by noon on the 17th of February for our Board of Trustee elections. Jeff Nesta will be presenting Keep a True Lent, based on a book by Charles Fillmore. Books are available in our library or can be purchased through our Unity bookstore. Contact Nancy Keeney, and Nancy is right over there. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, and you can sign up on the sign-up sheet in the foyer. Also, please stop by and see Nancy in the bookstore for any unique Valentine gifts that you might like to get for a special person. Gifts made by the Prayer Shawl Ministry are between one and $3 and a donation. Is that correct? Okay, thank you. Excellent. And there are a lot more events going on at Unity, so if you go to unityofmadisonalloneword.org, check out our website and you'll find other activities going on that might interest you.
Joy, the slide went up there, but you didn't reiterate that next Sunday is our annual meeting, so a week from today.
Okay, I might have missed that. Thank you very much, Nancy. It didn't.
There will be pizza after the service.
Oh, well, there you have it. So show up for the annual meeting next week for pizza, right? All right, thank you very much for that. And now, I've had a great delight in meeting some of our newcomers today. So we have wonderful new people that are joining us today for the first time. And if you'd like more information about Unity, please go to unityofmadison.org or help yourself to a welcome packet that's back on the back table and learn a little bit more about us, as well as coming downstairs for hospitality so that we can get to know you better as well. And now let's say our affirmation together to share in our abundance. Together, Unity of Madison is abundantly blessed. Creative people are drawn to us. Divine ideas flow through us. Financial resources bless us. And with God as our source, we can accomplish mighty works together. And at this time, we'll sing "Thank You for Choosing to Be Here" as you greet your neighbors in a manner that's comfortable for you. And this morning, we'll offer our thanks again. Our special music will be provided by our lead musician, Pete Calgaro. And our message about the power of love will be given to us by our own licensed Unity teacher, Barry Roberts. Looking forward to that. And our gratitude of the week, who needs a cape, is to John Panuska. John handled the lighting issues and plumbing issues in the women's bathroom. And you know, that's important. So we thank you very, very much, John. Your service is truly appreciated. John, wave your hand. Thank you. Most appreciated. Okay, now let's center ourselves for the reading of the Daily Word. Today's word is compassion. Whether in my community or across the world, many people face hardships. As a member of the human family, I'm inspired to undertake compassionate action and help however I can. Sometimes just a powerful thought or simple blessing can make a powerful difference in someone's life. Other times, I may be able to take a more direct action. I may listen to someone deeply as they share the concerns of their heart, or I may volunteer to drive them someplace or complete errands for them. Regardless of the form of my compassionate action takes, I am motivated to be of sacred service, to bring the love and the care of God into manifest form through my decisive action. The scripture reading that accompanies our daily word today is from Matthew 14, verse 14. Valentine Day is on the 14th. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. And our affirmation, reading together, here we go together. Acts of loving compassion build my strength. And now we'll have special music. Thank you.
Thank you, Pete. And after that, and all you need is love, you could say, we're done now. And just move on. But I have a few things to say first, as usual. Okay. So thank you. Thank you all for being here. Welcome. Good morning. I'm Barry Roberts, and I'm happy to be here today. And last week, I did an overview of the 12 spiritual powers that our co-founder, Charles Fillmore, put together and talked about and studied. And one of those powers is love. Okay. So today, since it's February and Valentine's Day and all that stuff coming up, I thought, well, that's perfect. We'll focus on love, the power of love today. So that's what we're going to do. First of all, when I say I love something, what does that mean? It can mean many different things. It's like, I love this food. I love this place. I love this community. I love your hair. I love whatever. Okay, so we use the word love in many contexts to mean many things. Next slide. And the Greeks, ancient Greeks, came up with 8 forms of love to kind of express all these different things. And I'm not gonna talk about all of them in any detail, but we're gonna focus on one or two. But you know, there's the romantic love, there's community, team, group love, there's family love, brother, sister, mother, father, all those kinds of things. There's self-love, and that is an interesting one. Maniac love, that's called the Super Bowl. So when you see some of the people dressed up in all their costumes and their face paint and all that kind of stuff, and they love their team. Okay, that's another way of looking at it. It is Super Bowl Sunday, by the way, in case you didn't know that. But the main one we're going to focus on is agape, which is the spiritual love. And I'll read a little definition of it. Agape is what some call spiritual love. It is an unconditional love, bigger than ourselves, a boundless compassion, an infinite empathy. Agape is the purest form of love, free from desires and expectations. So agape spiritual love is our focus, and like I said, there's many kinds of love, and we're going to talk about some examples of those later. None of them are bad. They're just different expressions and different aspects of the same wonderful thing that we have in all of us, and every part of humanity has this. Okay. Next slide, please. So, first of all, love is a spiritual power, the ultimate attractive force. It attracts, it brings things together in love, in harmony. And Charles Fillmore, our co-founder, said, love, the pure essence of being that binds together the whole human family. In divine mind, love is the power that joins and binds in divine harmony the universe and everything in it, great harmonizing principle known to humanity. So love is everywhere, and it, in a spiritual love, it can only be good. Okay? So that's one of the key things, is that love is good. It can only be good. And it can only share good and create good. That is an essence. And it does that through harmonizing everything that's going on in the universe and in our hearts, including our hearts, and bringing it together. And for us to focus on that, because what else is out there? There's a lot of talk about separation and how things are better or worse or, you know, from other people. That isn't what we're talking about. Real pure love harmonizes and brings people hearts together. It doesn't separate. So it's the ultimate attractive force. You've also may have seen in the Bible and other places, God is love. Okay? So if God is love, what was it? If God is love and love is blind, then Ray Charles is love. That's what someone told me the other day. Or Stevie Wonder, whoever. Okay. But God is love. And if we think of it that way, we are all in love and we are all God in love. And that's our mission, to share that. Again, it can only be good. And it's a creative force. When we're in the mode of love, a lot of creative things come out. Now, just Pete and everyone here that does music, that's a great form of love, right? That's shared with us and comes from the heart and it touches all of our hearts. And so the creation power of love is dramatic. Okay. So next slide. So expressing love then comes in all we do. It shows us, what we do shows us what our level of love, understanding, and expression is. So our behavior, our actions, how we treat people. Okay? How we treat others. Today's daily word was on compassion, right? So do we have compassion? To what degree do we have compassion? Even to those that we don't necessarily like or don't agree with or don't really even understand sometimes. But we can see them in love. And one story that goes back to the Dalai Lama and Tibetan monks and things, and when one of them was imprisoned for like 3 years, it was him and about 150 other monks that got imprisoned, and hard labor and all these kinds of things, and really tortured for like 3 years. And from about 150, that the people that survived were about 30, and he was one of them. And at the end, when he was freed, you know what his concern was losing compassion for the guards, because then he would have lost his love. All right, and that's really incredible love, to be able to go through all of that in real life and still say, I am going to be love regardless of what these people do to me, and see love in others. So that's a challenge. And then self, we, not in an egotistical way, like I'm great, but self-love, taking care of ourselves, being good to ourselves. And that's everything from the physical and taking care of our bodies with whatever nutrition, exercise, yada, yada, those kinds of things, but also in our self-talk, right? Are we talking lovingly to ourselves? Are we seeing ourselves as a source of love and acknowledging that in how we think about ourselves? That is what we need to be doing, because when we see that in ourselves, then we can see what is ours to share from that love. What is ours to help grow that love? And we're part of this whole world and universe, and so when our consciousness is in love, we're building love consciousness. That is doing something. So self-love is, and it's one of the nine Greek loves, is very important. One of the things that Charles Fillmore said in The Power of Love, it insists that all is good, and by refusing to see anything but good, it causes that quality finally to appear uppermost and in all things. So it helps us see good, even if what's physically three-dimensionally going on may not be something that we really like or feel is loving. And kind of the three main ways he talks about expressing the way we as human beings express love is one, thought. So in our minds, To think love is not easy because it means you must think good of all people and things as you approach daily situations, even when people and things are not showing their good side. Which happens, right? There's times we deal with things, but our mind, we have to see and think love. That's one key way we express it. Another way is through our words, our language, what we share there. Speak love by affirming the divine love you hold within, whether aloud with others or in quiet in your spiritual practice. So speak love is part of our mission. And then actions, our behaviors. The purest action of love is living true to your heart. Acts of kindness will reveal the love you are, as will acts of giving, whether you're giving time or money. So our actions, how we treat other people, are we compassionate, are we understanding, are we forgiving, all these things are actions of love. And this is from the Daily Word last week, January 28th, but it talks about kindness. When I show kindness, I am expressing the love of God. Okay. My words are guided by the Christ within, and my actions flow from the same spirit of wisdom, compassion, and peace. So here we have our mind, our actions, and here's an action part. When I open the door for someone or donate to a worthwhile cause, I trigger a chain reaction that goes on and on. The smallest act of kindness not only blesses the receiver, but inspires other acts of kindness, prompted by the same spirit of love and compassion that lives in every heart. So acts of kindness are a form of love, and it can come naturally, and it can come beautifully. Next, what we're going to do is stop listening to me. Now, what I want to do is actually get some audience participation and have people share something that you have experienced love. Whether it's of yourself, of others, and whether you gave love or received love or even just observed maybe something going on between people that you thought was a great act of love. And it doesn't have to be great. It can be very small, simple things. You see up here the heart. Where's my heart? Here's my... And I use that as an example because this is something that comes from way back in my youth ed days and high school days. And this heart is we use to do heart talks is what we call. It's basically a beanbag heart. And we'd sit in a circle and whoever had the heart had the floor. And everyone else just listened lovingly. So it was great exercise. Listening is love. It's an action of love. So whether it's that, I just wanted to share that as a simple example for myself. What I'd like to do is I'm going to go out here and ask for anyone to share a quick example of love that you've shared, you've received, or you've seen others do. Okay, and I'll start over here, and then I'll come over there. So who has an example?
My sister came up from Iowa this weekend, so love was reciprocal. It was really great.
The 5-year-old and 7-year-old that lives across the street from me came over yesterday spontaneously, knocked on the door, wanted to know if I'd play hide and seek with them. So it was a lot of fun.
So I was just talking to my mom the other day about how I was sick to my stomach and after something that I ate and I didn't ask for anything or any help, but my mom just sent me some glutamine to help my stomach, and I just thought it was nice that she did that without, you know, being prompted or asked, and it was a very kind, generous action.
Thank you.
I euthanized my dog, so he didn't have to suffer anymore. And there's been a really outpouring of love towards me following it.
I was just telling Amy about the time my mom came visiting from out of state and stayed up during the night when my son would not sleep, my infant son, and took over for me, which was amazing.
Thank you.
I'm sitting close to Ann Zenner, and I hope she doesn't mind, but this week in the paper, one of the greatest acts of love I've ever seen was when she said in court that she forgave the person who'd caused a lot of trauma for her life, and that was just amazing. It brought tears to the judge's eyes, to everyone in the courtroom's eyes, and I'm sure for the man that she forgave, it changed the rest of his life.
When my cancer recurred in 2018, I had 8 rounds of chemo followed by immune therapy. During the time of my chemotherapy, I had a wonderful care team of people that signed up every week. Two or three of them would sign up. They would take me to doctor's appointments. They would come and Joanne Rizika helped me clean my storage room. Nancy shredded all my documents. They just did anything that I wanted them to do. And it was just such a blessing to know I didn't have to ask. Every week they would call me. And I felt so blessed. And so in that way, I give up.
Thank you.
Over here.
Yeah. Ann Zenner always invites me to sing in the choir.
I'm 73 years old and I have osteoarthritis and a very uncomfortable ankle. And as you know, we got one heck of a snowstorm and I had to go to my chiropractor and there was nothing but solid ice and snow all the way up to the point where you go from the street onto the sidewalk, and I'm standing there going, I cannot walk over this. I'm going to fall. I was just like terrified. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, this car pulls up and this guy rolls his window down and he says, are you okay? And I said, I cannot get across the sidewalk. And he said, I'll be right there. And he came out of his car and he turned out to be a policeman. And I didn't know it. And he walked me across the sidewalk, which is this long. Of ice, solid ice. So I felt like I had an angel show up.
One of my blinds broke in it, and my granddaughter came out. It's a huge blind in it, and she's fixing it and bringing it back today. But tomorrow in it, she had breast cancer, and she will be undergoing surgery again. And so all of her mother put out asking for help and in making some meals and that. And so I made her soup already, which is her favorite, and then I'm going over to make waffles for them tomorrow.
Thank you.
I have lost my leg. It's been 4 years now, and I cannot think of all the times people have opened doors for me and been very kind to me. And I know one thing in particular, this last week, I fell getting out of my car. And all of a sudden, there's a guy appear and, here, I'll help you. And he helped me get up. I didn't know who he was. It was just a stranger that is grateful.
Thank you. Anyone else? All right, so awesome. You know, we can all do it, right? We are all capable of expressing love and being the great spirit that we are. And we can do it in many ways. It's having that loving heart and that loving intention and seeing it in the world. So the people that helped other people without asking, they saw and out of love served in some way, right? And we all can do that. And we all are doing that in some form. So I'm going to wrap up today with a couple affirmations. Let us say these and state these together, please. First, I am alive with love. Next, I express true love to attract and express good in all that I do. Let's do the first one again and really, really, really own it. I am alive with love. Amen. Namaste. And now is the time we take a few minutes to be still. So I invite you just to sit comfortably, put anything down, and just breathe in and out, relaxed, feeling your breath leading relaxation throughout your body. You may want to close your eyes or gaze ahead, whatever you're comfortable with. And in this time of stillness, I affirm my love and all love, and all that I am is love. And I see my heart opening like a blooming flower that has many petals, like a rose or some other flower. And each one of those petals is a way I express love. I bring love into the world. I bring love into everyone I meet, everyone I see. I bring love to my friends and family. And I bring love to myself, healing all my error thinking, healing in every way I need. That is the power of love. We are all full, beautiful expressions of love. And we see that in ourselves, in our community, in our world, and the universe. We see the harmonizing power of love in all. And at this time, we'll take a moment in the silence to affirm and focus on love in all. And as we move forward out of this space, I commit to keeping my heart open, keeping that blossom of love and energy of love flowing in me and through me as an expression of love to build love throughout the world. I am open, receptive, and giving of the divine love that is in all. And for this wonderful blessing, and this wonderful ability, and this wonderful power of love, I am grateful. Namaste.
Barry talked about speaking love. And so I would invite us all today, this morning, to sing love. So this is a chant. I call it the love chant. It's literally one word, sung over and over again. After you sing love like 1,000 times, I just am curious to see like how your energy shifts, like what kind of mood you're in or whatever after we do this. So it's basically two notes. We sing love. We sing it over and over. At some point, I add some words over the top, and we'll see what happens. Here we go.
Love.
Thank you, Pete. That's like a big group hug that you can feel permeating right out our doors and into the community and the world. That was gorgeous. Thank you so much. Okay, now is the time that we lovingly collect our tithes and offerings. So if you would please take your tithes and offerings and place them over your heart. And do we repeat this with me, or are we just... say our offertory blessing. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, God. If the ushers would please come forward, and we'll sing all that I have. And if the ushers would please come forward. And let's warm up some gratitude for all of our ushers and all of these wonderful tithes and offerings. We are grateful for these tithes and offerings. We bless them and send them forth to do their great and mighty works. Thank you, God. And now we have an affirmation to build and grow our youth ed program. So together, we now open our hearts to the children and families seeking a welcoming spiritual community filled with light and love. And so it is. Amen. And I do believe we have some little spiritual beings. They just went up to get them. So.
Thank you. We had a lot of fun today. We did a lot of things. It was kind of a party day. We did talk a little bit about receiving messages from feathers and stones. We had a little scavenger hunt outside where everyone chose some, well, they found stones and feathers, and that was really fun. Simon found a special little bear, and I told them about a game that we play at home with such items. So maybe they'll each do that at home with something special, including little bear, perhaps. And gosh, we moved our bodies, we danced, we crafted. So it was a good day. So does anyone want to share their experience? Simon, do you want to share? You want to pass? Do you guys want to share? Anything? No? Okay.
What did your stone say?
Yeah. Do you want to share what your stone was telling you and your feathers?
Stones and fossils, and the feathers told me keep collecting the feathers. I changed my voice when I talk, so there.
All right. So it was really easy for Simon to get that message from nature. That was really cool. And sometimes it just takes a little bit more practice. So if you guys want to keep hearing messages from your stones and feathers, just keep trying. Thank you.
It is warm up here. So wonderful. Thank you so much, Jessica and Jennifer and all the volunteers up in Youth Ed. So again, let's warm up some energy for our Youth Ed department and bless our Youth Ed department together. Children and Youth Ed department, we love you. We bless you. We appreciate you. And we behold the Christ you are. Thank you. Now, why don't you find your loved ones and join them, and we can stand for our peace song.
Every one of us sharing our love in our life, and we affirm together our prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. The presence of God watches over us. I am presence. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well.